41 upalas in the term. What we can say in the Acharya, they have mentioned 41 upalas, whereas within 10 to 21 upalas, we can get this Arka Lavana. And even on your gas also, you can prepare this Arka Lavana. It doesn't mean that you have 1 upalas, because as the science goes on advancing, we have to be adjust with that. Okay, so on the gas also, you keep that sharava above the gas, and you just see that bottom of the sharava should become a red hot. Till that time period, you have to, because you have done the Sandhi Bandhana, it's very difficult to open it once again, and you just see whether that Saindhava is properly mixed with the Arka Patra has become blackish or not. It's very difficult. So to identify that that sharava is there, na, that sharava, it should be of a red hot in color. Till that time period, you have to keep it on a gas, then off that gas and allow it for Swanga Shita, and remove that Sandhibandhita, what the sharava is to be removed, and you can get that something grayish black. Okay, grayish black color of that Arkalavana, it is to be collected. And this, the dosage of this Arkalavana of 250 to 1 gram, it can be given twice a day. And the anupana is dadhi, takra, or the plain jala also. But what I suggest is dadhi, it can be given, or with the takra also, it can be indicated. If both is not there, then jala can be given. And this is indicated in Gulma, Pliha, Udararoga, and in Gulma. It can be given with the Eranda Taila and with the followed by the lukewarm water. Okay, so this Gulma, in the sense, in my OPD, I have seen a small, what we can say, the I cannot say this is a Gulma, but a small abscess like was there, okay, at the right arm of the patient. Then I have given this Arka Taila, okay, with Eranda Taila and lukewarm water, and it gave a result with that. Okay, Pliha with the Kumariswarasa. Then in Udararoga, it can be given with the Gomutra and Eranda Taila. This Udararoga, I think I have given in a Jalodhara. Actually, in a Jalodhara patient, I have given this Arka Taila with Gomutra and Eranda Taila also. Okay, in indigestion, if indigestion is there, because now it is a lockdown and you are preparing very delicious food and you are eating and indigestion, obviously, then with the dadhi, it can be given. Prepare Arka Taila. Prepare a delicious food, prepare Arka Taila and give that dadhi after the food. Okay. Then in the indigestion, it can be given. Even in the constipation, with the lukewarm water, this Arka Taila can be given. And this Arka Taila is contraindicated in a hyper tensive patients because it containing lavana. Sorry. It
Ma'am,
containing
Arka Taila
lavana.
or Arka Lavana?
Sorry. Arka Lavana. Sorry. Arka Lavana, it is contraindicated in hypertensive patients because it containing lavana, and this cannot be, Arka Lavana cannot be given for a long term because it containing kshara, and it mainly affect the quality and the quantity of the sperm in a male. Okay, so for a long term it cannot be given. Okay, so this is about the Arka Lavana. Then I told the I'll explain regarding the Shvasari Lavana. It is another one, this one, and this is the best. I'm using in asthma patients, in shwasa patients. Okay, so this is the same as Arka Lavana only. Whereas in Arka Lavana, we are keeping the Arka Patra and we are sprinkling the Saindhava. Whereas in this Shvasari Lavana, you have to smear Arka Patra with the Goghruta. Okay, smear each Arka Patra with Goghruta and keep it above that Saindhava is to be sprinkled. And the remaining procedure is same as Arka Lavana. Okay, and 250 to 500 milligram, it can be given with the honey, and it gives a best result in the shwasa. Okay, so in acute conditions, if acute conditions shwasa patients are there, then 2 to 3 times it can be given. Okay, to a patient, every means within an hour, 2 to 3 times it can be given to a patient. It mainly helps to expel the kapha which is present inside that. Okay, so this is about the shwasari lavana, same as Arka Lavana. Okay, next is Vidangadi Kshara. It is explained in Plihodara Chikitsa by Acharya Charaka. It is also very easy to prepare. Okay, and this, I think the some materials are not available now in your kitchen or in your home, but after this lockdown time period, you can prepare it. Okay, and it is giving a very best result in Plihodara Chikitsa. Okay, the ingredients present inside that are, I won't go for the shloka because it's very, time is very less. Okay, it needed the vidanga. You need shunti, chitraka, and vacha. Vidanga, shunti, चित्रक एंड वचा मेक दीज इन अ नॉट कोर्स पाउडर मेक इट अ स्मॉल पीसेस ऑफ दीज थिंग्स विडंग यू नो विडंग दट इज अ स्मॉल वन पीसेस यू कैन प्रिपेयर शुंठी ऑल्सो देन चित्रक देन वचा स्मॉल पीसेस आर टू बी टेकन टेक अ मृत पात्र और मृत घटिका इफ यू टेक अ घट स्मॉल घट देन इट्स ओके गुड इट इज हियर ओके देन मिक्स ऑल फोर इनग्रीडियंट्स ओके देन कीप इट इन अ घट देन अप्लाई घी अबव दैट ओके देन आई पुट अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ अ मिल्क मिल्क मीन्स यू शुड नॉट पुट मैक्सिमम क्वांटिटी ऑफ अ मिल्क ओनली 4 to 5 spoons ऑफ मिल्क इज सफिशियंट ओके सो हियर द क्वांटिटी इफ यू टेक 100 grams ऑफ ईच विडंग शुंठी चित्रका एंड वचा देन 5 to 6 spoons ऑफ मिल्क इज सफिशियंट देन एड अ 2 to 3 spoons ऑफ घी एंड मिक्स इट प्रॉपरली ओके मिक्स इट प्रॉपरली देन एड साइंधव लवण टू दिस ओके दट साइंधव लवण इज ऑल्सो ऑफ अबाउट 20 to 30 grams 20 grams saindhava lavana okay not 30 20 grams of saindhava lavana is to be added here and again you just mix it properly so with this saindhava lavana with the help of ghrita and dugdha it mainly sticks with the vidanga shunti chitraka and vacha okay then close this pot here sandhi bandhana is not necessary close it this pot as it is and keep it on agni here also the same as arkapatra when that bottom will become red hot then remove that patra or take it out mix it properly pound it with the kalvayantra and you keep this powder as it is with you okay so this with the 250 to 300 milligram twice a day it can be given to a patient and gomutra as a anupana can be given in gulma pliha and even in a medo vikara also it can be given this vidanga dikshara I have used in medo vikara especially in medo vikaras it has given a very best result many patients comes to you regarding the medo vikaras okay so at that time you can give this vidangadi kshara to the patient okay next is okay this is about the vidangadi kshara next is dhupana this dhupana and now regarding this corona and all I have so only because of that only I have selected this dhupana okay so this dhupana you can prepare in the home and I'll explain you now this dupana according to kashyapa samhita he has a what we can say he has given a beautiful chapter on dupana only okay and dupana this is having a very broad spectrum on aesthetic psychological as well as medical significance okay even if you have a small kid in your home then dupana daily we are doing dupana we are dupana can be given okay and this corona means dupana is a must This Acharya Kashyapa has explained three types of dhupana. One is dhupa, that is the fumigation. Another one is anudhupa, that is the subsequent fumigation he is saying. Then in pratidhupa, that is anti-fumigation. Okay, so mainly three types of fumigation has been explained. And even in the charaka also, in charaka, Advivarniya Chikitsa Adhyaya in Jwara, Unmada, Kumaragara, Kushta, etc. In all these chapters, he has explained regarding the Dhupana. And even Sushruta also, Rakshogna, Karma, Dhupana has been mentioned. And the Dhupana materials are mainly having the Kushtahara, Krimigna, Kandugna, Vranahara, and even sulfur compounds like Haratala, Manashila, and animal products like the hair, nails, horns, etc. can be used. And this dhupana is very important because nowadays you know about that all out mosquito that this repellents and all is there and maximum patients are having the complaining of the breathlessness or what we can say the irritations the toxicity will be more they are very hypersensitivity with the reactions what we are using so this dhupana if we prepare in a home it's very eco friendly very cheaper and you can sell it how much you want and it is very easy to prepare here this dhupana actually I have taken even in the samhitas also it is there but some part I have added that what I am preparing that I am telling you so the main here I have taken as a wood powder you know when you go to any this wood craft and all will be there na they have wood powder and they are throwing without any using of that so take a wood powder I'll tell you that quantity also you just dry, note it down you can prepare it easily okay so 50 gram of wood powder is to be taken then gugulu you know gugulu here no need of shodhana also if you do the shodhana also then it's okay 150 gram of gugulu is to be taken nimba patra powder it is easily available 50 gram haridra powder it is also easily available 20 grams then vacha churna or vacha powder that is of 20 grams then ghrita I have added here 50 grams arkapatra, dried arkapatra here, not arkaswarasa. You take arkapatra, dry it, and that powder can be used of the 50 gram. And even the cow dung, that is vanopalas, okay, that is to be taken. That the dried vanopalas are to be taken. That is of 4 vanopalas is sufficient for this quantity. And the sariva of 20 gram because of a smell. And even sariva is also having the properties good. That is to be taken. All these ingredients are to be taken. And because of the gugulu, you just put a little bit of water inside that. It will become a stickiness will be more. And you add, go on adding all the ingredients one by one over this. Okay, so it will become just like fine paste like form. Okay, so if you have a 5 ml syringe or 2 ml syringes in your home, or else you just go and buy that syringe. Okay, then you just cut the nozzle will be there. Na? Cut the nozzle of that syringe. Okay, I'll show you. I have one, this one. See, you have to cut here so that it can be opened. Okay, you just remove it. It's like this. And take this kalka and put it in here. Take that kalka, put it here. Then you just go and push this. Then go on pushing. Go on pushing. And from here, that what that kalka will come out. And how much that length you want. Then you cut it here and keep it aside and dry it in a sunlight. Okay, see here. I have done like this. This is dhupana, and one thing is you have to dry it in a sunlight properly, or else the chances of breaking of this dhupa is more. Okay, so this is the dhupana. The ingredients I think you have noted down. Then this is even in each every day in the morning as well as even in the evening also you can use this dhupana in your home. It is instead of all these mosquito repellents and all, it is the best thing you can. And if you want to add something else inside that, this is what I am using. Okay. If you want to add something to this, then it is very good, well and good. You can use this. Okay. This is dhupana. And one thing, okay, regarding this dhupana also, I remembered one patient. One of my patient, that is that he's of 14 or 15 year old. Okay, and continuously cough is there to that patient. Okay, I have given almost all the whatever the Ayurvedic medicines are there, everything I have given to the patient, but cough will not subside. Then I don't know, in my mind, I just asked the patient that what the muscular repellents or what you are using, whether you are using the net or any all out or any that coil and all. Then that patient told that they are using that coil. Okay, so then I thought that because of that coil, maybe the cough, because of the irritation, that cuff is not subsided. Then I told that patient, stop the muscle, what they are using, and I have given that the dhupana for this, and within 3 to 4 days, that cuff subsided. After, I think I have given him, regarding 2 months, I have given that for the patient, I have given, and I tried almost all our Ayurvedic medicines on this. And simply at the last I got, because of this muscular repellent, the patient has got the irritation and the cough will not subside. So, see, such type of patients also will come to you. And at that time, this dhupana will give the best result. Okay. So, this is about the dhupana. Next is okay. I told na, I am being an Rasa Shastra, na, I cannot leave our Rasa Shastra Dravya. Here I'll explain you one simple bhasma, that is you can prepare in your home only. Don't think that bhasma means we need gajaputa, varahaputa, kapodaputa, ardha gajaputa, that puta, this puta and all. Okay, so this is a simple one, this is called as a ingula bhasma. Okay, so I won't go for the shloka and all. I'll just give you the ingredients, this quantity and how it is to be prepared. Okay, so here we need Shuddha Hingula. Shuddha Hingula, doing the Shodhana of a Hingula, it's not a big task. Take Ardhraka Swarasa and give the Bhavana, or do the Mardana for 7 days, you will get a Shuddha Hingula. That you can do in your home only. That is one Karsha Pramana Shuddha Hingula, that is of 12 grams. Okay, then Shuddha Haratala is to be taken. And this Shuddha Haratala, you can take you can do easily in the Shodhana in your home also with the Churnodaka, and you can use. That is 375 milligram. Lavanga Churna, it is easily available. Ardhraka Swarasa is also easily available. That also you can take. So, Lavanga Churna of 1 gram, then ardhaka swarasa of 24 ml is to be taken. Okay, so now I'll tell you how to keep all these ingredients. Take one sharava. First, a small sharava is okay because the ingredients or the quantity are very less. Small sharava is to be taken, and in that keep that shuddha hingula 12 gram. Okay, then before that sprinkle that lavanga churna a little bit. 1 gram has been mentioned. That is half gram you just sprinkle. Above that you keep shuddha hingula. Then shuddha haratala is to be placed above that. That is the powder form only. Then add ardhraka swarasa to that. Then again above the half gram what is there, and that the remaining lavana churna is to be sprinkled. Only this much. Okay. Then close that sharava. Again sandhi bandhana is to be done. And it is kept on a agni. Okay. Here agni means 3 hours you have to keep it on a agni. 3 hours because we cannot see to open opening the sharava and all. So 3 hours you have to keep here for that purpose. What I suggest is use that valuka yantra here. Okay, valuka yantra means the temperature can be maintained. We need here the maintained temperature. That you have a half cutted pot in your home, put a valuka inside that and keep this in on the sharava. Okay, so you will. Okay, I think you can see. This is a red color, hingula bhasma. Okay, and this is the powder form. It is not a powder form. That is a small, what we can say, like this. You can, I think you can see like this hingula. We will get, and this is to be taken, and it is powder, and it is to be kept with you. This hingula bhasma, it is giving very best result in kasa. Is kaphaja kasa, especially in kaphaja kasa. Even I am using this in the asthma patient also. The matra is about only 150 milligram. This is can be given with the madhu, as well as I am giving to a patient with the palandu swarasa. You know palandu? Palandu swarasa is to be taken and madhu, as well as 150 grams of hingula bhasma in a divided dose. 150 gram in the morning, 150 gram in the evening can be given. And palandu swarasa, it's available, easily available in your home. If at all, if you, the patient won't, because the pungent smell will be there, then with the, what we can say, any ardhraka swarasa also it can be given. Okay. Nagavalli swarasa also it can be given to a patient. But I prefer palandu swarasa with madhu of about 150 milligram of that hingula bhasma to a patient can be given. And it gives a very, very, very best result. I'm using in my clinic, this hingula bhasma. Okay. Then another one thing regarding the rasaushadhi only. In the Charaka Samhita, kaphaja chardi nashaka yoga. I think if you go and see at the chardi yogadikara, in that for kaphaja chardi nashaka, Achara Charaka has mentioned that is manashila. Only the manashila to be used here. Okay, that is a shuddha manashila. That the lakshana of kaphaja chardi, that is tandra is there, asya madhura avastha is there, then atinidrata is there, aruchi is there, and anga gauravata will be there. And that whatever the vomiting is there, that vomiting is of the snigdha van, gadhura, what is ghana is there, madhura is there, and it is of a shuddha kapha can be observed. So these are the lakshana of the kaphaja chardi. So and vamana will not stop with this. Okay, we can give the modern medicines, that is everything, then whatever our Ayurveda medicines are, that can also be given. Whereas this kaphaja chardi, it will not stop. If you give the medicine also, then also the patient vomits. Okay, so this is has given very I think good result. It can be given. So you need only shuddha manashila. Only you take manashila and do the shodhana and you keep with you. And this rasaushadhi, if you keep as it is for a longer time period, for 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years also, after doing shodhana, nothing will happen to this. Okay, so only the preparation, it needs a little bit time, because shodhana of manashila, that you know, that is to be, shodhana of manashila is to be taken and is keep with you. That is here, see, I have. I think you can see that manashila, that is a reddish, yellowish color, a tinge, a powder form is there. Whenever I need, I just make it a powder. I have kept it shodhita one only. Whenever I need, I just take a kalva yantra, I just powder it and give it to the patient, because this is, you know, it is a vishadravyas arsenic compound. So it is to be kept after shodhana also, it is to be kept away from kids, in a safer side, I am of ourselves, we can keep it with the away from the kids. Okay, so Shuddha Manashila is to be taken of 5 to 8 grams only. That much is sufficient. And add Animbus Parasa with that, and Madhu can be given. Okay, Shuddha Manashila of 5 to 8 grams, then Nimbus Varasa as well as the Madhu can be taken, just mix and given to a patient. 2 to 3 times can be given to a patient within one hour or 2 hours only. Whatever the symptoms are there, the lakshana are there of this Kapaja Chardi, it subsides. Okay, so only this much, I think 7 preparations I have explained today. And it is very easy to be used in your household only. And all the materials are available. And I'll say only all the best to all of you, those who have heard about this. And you start preparing. Be an Ayurvedic. Be stay at home. Safe at home. Be healthy at home by using Ayurvedic medicines. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any queries?
Any inquiries? Any doubts?
Oh.
Oh.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello, ma'am. Good evening.
Hello. Good evening. Yes, sir.
Ma'am, you told that Manashila, Shuddha Manashila, 5 to 8 gram or mg, ma'am? Mg, it may be mg, I think. 5 to 8 mg. Hello. Hello.
Hello, sir.
It is 5 to 8 mg, I think.
MG, sir.
Okay.
MG only it is. Sorry, it's my tongue mistake. It is. I told it's a gram. It's a milligram only, sir. Because arsenic drugs to be given in a milligram only. Almost all of Russia's drugs, yes.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Yeah. Yeah.
In that one yoga, you told Hingula Rasa, preparation of Hingula.
Basma.
Basma.
Ha, sir.
In that. What is the Siddhi Lakshana? How only 3 hours or more than how we'll come to know? Like in Trifalamasi also doing when it stops the dhuma, when it stops na, that
yes
till we'll fry that.
Yes that
so
is
here,
okay sir, okay. Okay, I'll tell you that here because Sandhi Bandhana we have done. So 3 hours means you will get the Lavanga Churna what we have applied over that. I told we have to sprinkle that Lavanga Churna about that Ardhaka Swarasa. That Lavanga Churna will become very blackish in color. Okay, and even that Ardhaka Swarasa what we have kept now, if it's everything will be dried only, and we'll see that Hingula is there. Hingula is of that is a Hamsapa, that is reddish in color. Hingula is there after Shodhana also. That reddish color will become a little bit blackish in color, sir. That is a Siddhi Lakshana, okay. We can say, because this Hingula Basma has been explained in Yogaratnakara only. Because Hingula, I think you have seen almost Hingula using the Hingula only.
Okay.
So Hingula Basma, nowhere we will get regarding the Hingula Basma preparation, only the Hingula Basma. Okay. The blackish color of longitude is observed, as well as all the kept inside is, and even the color of the Hingula can be seen. I'll show you. That is to be taken first. In that, small piece of these four. Keep it in a butter. Okay, Okay. No need of doing any sandhi bandhana and all. Keep it on a agni. Then you observe the bottom of a pot when it will become a red hot. Then you just keep it, take it out. Then you just observe that vidanga shunti and all. Now it will become very just like with from your hand only they will break. Just a brittleness can be observed, not that the total brittleness. Only brittleness can be observed. Then you take it out. Then you just do the mardana and keep it.
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಶುಂಠಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಡ್ರೈ ತಗೋಬೇಕಾ ಅಥವಾ ಪೌಡರ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕಾ ಅಥವಾ ವೆಟ್ಟ ತಗೋಬೇಕಾ ಮೇಡಮ್?
ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಡ್ರೈ ತಗೋಬೇಕು ಸರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಾನು
ಚೂರ್ಣ.
ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಪೌಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಚೂರ್ಣ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಪೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಮೀಟರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್.
ಓಕೆ,
ಶುಂಠಿ ಚಿತ್ರಕ ಅಂಡ್ ವಚ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪೀಸಸ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿಡಂಗ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅದು ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪೀಸಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಎಲ್ಲ ಪೀಸ್ ಗಳಿಗೆ ಅದು ಹತ್ತಬೇಕು. ದುಗ್ಧ ಮತ್ತೆ ಹಾಕಿ ಸೈಂಧವ ಹಾಕಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಸೈಂಧವ ಅದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ದೆನ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಆನ್ ಅಗ್ನಿ.
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಸರ್.
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಶ್ವಾಸಾರಿ ಲವಣ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಎನಿ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅನುಭೂತ ಯೋಗ?
ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್
ಸರ್? ಶ್ವಾಸಾರಿ ಲವಣ.
ಶ್ವಾಸಾರಿ ಲವಣ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. It's a reference. I'll give you the reference. I don't know where now I have forgotten. I'll just give you the reference of that in a group. Okay.
Oh, okay.
All whatever I have mentioned except the Dhupana one, everything is a classical prepared only.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Dhupana is also a classical one. I have added something to that. Whatever I want, Anna, that I have that wood powder and all I have added inside that. Okay. The remaining everything is of a classical preparation only. I'll give you the reference of this Shvasari Lavana. Okay.
ವೆರಿ
ಗುಡ್.
ಅರ್ಕಲವನ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲಿ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. So Arka is one of the Vishadravya. So it is called like Arka is Vishadravya. So when we are giving the internal, I heard like, so it is the Visha. So the clinical practice is very less regarding Arka Lavana. So is it like that, ma'am? Or we can use it?
You can use it. I'm using. Because practically I am using. I don't have any doubt. Yeah, except that it is a Vishadravya. Okay, it comes under the Upavishadravya Arka. Okay, I accept that. But I think apart from me, Dravya Guna people, they can put more light on it. Arka, Arka, everything. I just... because so Arka Labana, you give... patients, no problem in that. I am using. I have that much of confidence. Oh. And if you okay, prepare it genuinely, you can use it and you can give it. No problem in that.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am. But in on the ma'am, so in Arka, we have two types, ma'am. One is with white flower, another one with bluish color, purple color flower, ma'am.
Yes.
So which one is better, ma'am? So when I discussed with some other persons, that any we can take, sir, in regards to Dravya Guna. So
later on, I will also say the same thing.
So any you can take like that, ma'am.
Yes. According to me also, I'll also suggest the same thing. Anything, both you can, I told na Dravya Guna people put more light on this, but according to me, both the same result, only 5-10% or 2% changes can be seen. I told na, Sajala Narikela as Sajala Narikela, what I have explained, only slight changes can be observed in this both Arka, by Shweta Arka as well as that Pita Arka or some other Arka is there. Na? So slight changes can be observed. Apart from that, I don't think so drastic changes can be seen in that both are.
Okay, but thank you, ma'am.
Okay, yeah, welcome.
Hello.
Hello, good evening, ma'am.
Hello.
Yeah, good evening.
Hello.
Can we use this Arka Thailand psoriasis, ma'am?
Wait.
Hello.
Yeah, you can use. I told na, so this Arka Thaila can be used in almost all type of skin disorders. All type Kushtaroga, in what our Ayurveda, what they mentions that all type of skin disorders we can use this Arka Thaila.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Madam, regarding that Arka Lavana, the questions, it is Vishadravya. So, ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಗ್ನಿ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಲೈಕ್ ಅರ್ಕಪತ್ರ ನಾವು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ವಿಷ.
ಓಕೆ,
ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಅಗ್ನಿ ಸಂಸ್ಕಾರ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಕಲ್ ಡೋಸೇಜ್ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಹೇಳಿದಂಗೆ ಈಗ ಅರ್ಕಪತ್ರದ್ದು ಅದ್ ಲಕ್ಷಣಗಳು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅರ್ಕ ಲವಣ ಸಿದ್ಧಿ ಲಕ್ಷಣ ಲೈಕ್ ಗ್ರೇಷ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಟಿಂಚ್ ಕಲರ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸ್ಟವ್ ಮೇಲೆ ರೆಡ್ಡಿಶ್ ಆಗೋವರೆಗೂ ಇದ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಯಾವಾಗ ಅದ ಅಗ್ನಿ ಸಿದ್ಧ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಅದ್ರದ್ದು ವಿಷ ಲಕ್ಷಣಗಳೇನಿರ್ತದೆ ಅದ್ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದ್ ಹೋಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತಾನೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ವೆನ್ ಅವ್ರು ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ನಾವು ಅವ್ರು ಶೋಧಿತ ಅರ್ಕಪತ್ರ ತಗೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಸೈಂಧವ ಲವಣ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಆಗಿ ನಾವ್ ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾದ್ರು ತಗೊಳ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಕಾಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಇದು ವಿಷ ಲಕ್ಷಣ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಬಟ್ ನೀವ್ ಹೇಳಿರೋ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂತ ವಿಷ ಲಕ್ಷಣಗಳು ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಮೇಡಮ್. ಅದ
ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಮೇಲೆ ಏನು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಸೈಡ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಇಲ್ಲ.
ಅವರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ ಯಾರೋ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ, ಬಟ್ ನೀವು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಕಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ ಅದರದ್ದು. ಹಾ, ಸೋ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ
ಅನುಪಮ ತಿಳಿತ ರಾಕೇಶ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ಅನುಪಮ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅನುಪಮ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರಾಕೇಶ್ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು.
ಆಮೇಲೆ ಶ್ವೇತ ಅರ್ಕಲ ಅರ್ಕಪತ್ರ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಜನರಲಿ ನಾವು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಗೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಈಗ ನಾವು ಯಾವುದು ಈಗ ವಾತಕಂಟಕ ಅಥವಾ ಸಂಧಿಗತ ವಾತದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಈ ಫಿಟೀಸ್ ಕಫಾವೃತ ವಾತ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಆದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಟಿಫ್ನೆಸ್ ಹೆವಿನೆಸ್ ಆ ತರದ್ದಿದ್ರೆ ಜನರಲಿ ಲೈಕ್ ನೀವು ಯಾವ್ದು ಆಯಿಲ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೊಡ್ತೀರಿ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಗೆ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಮಿಯರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನ ಒಂದು ಬಾಂಡ್ಲಿಲೋ ಅಥವಾ ಹಂಚಲ್ಲೋ ವಾರ್ಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಪತ್ರ ಸ್ವೇದನ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕೊಡ್ಬೋದು ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಇನ್ ವಾತಕಂಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಜನರಲಿ ವಿಷ ಇದು ಯಾವ್ದು ಪಿಂಡ ತೈಲ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಸ್ನೇಹನ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೋದು. ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್
ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್.
ಇನ್ನ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಲೈಕ್ ಜನರಲಿ ಒಂದ್ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಹೇಳುವಂತದ್ದು ರಕ್ತ ಇದನ್ನ ತಗೋಬಹುದು ಅಂತ. ಬಟ್ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎವರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್
ಏರಿಯಾ. ಆ ಏರಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಸಿ ತಗೊಂಡೆ ದ್ರವ್ಯಗಳು ಬೆಳಿತಾವಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಏರಿಯಾ ವೈಸ್ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಸಿ ಸೋ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್
ರಾಕೇಶ್.
ಓಕೆ, someone has
handled madam ha idralli dhupanadalli helidralla. So igella dry powder helidru ni wood guggulu matte nimba patra churna ella.
Haudu
so adralli paste maadkobeku andre naavu en grita add maartivi ad maatra paste aguvantha
illa guggulu idiyalla guggulu idiyalla
ha guggulu andre idralli grita nu add maadbekalla
haudu haudu grita add maadbekalla 50 grams grita helidini nanu yakandre adu ni bengi hachidaga adakke hek bekala enadru grita bekala hakike tuppa. ಗುಗ್ಗುಲು ನೀವು ತಗೊಂಡಿರ್ತಿರಲ್ಲ ಗುಗ್ಗುಲಿಗೆ ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೀರ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೀರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಗುಗ್ಗುಲು ಸ್ಟಿಕಿನೆಸ್ ಇದ್ದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಗೋ ಆನ್ ಆಡಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಗ್ರುತನು ಹಾಕಿ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಾವು ಚಪಾತಿ ಹಿಟ್ಟೆಲ್ಲ ಕಲಿಸ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ ಆ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಿ ಬರ್ಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆನಾ?
ಅದನ್ನ
ನೀವು ಈ ಸಿರಿಂಜ್ ಒಳಗ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇವನ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅದು ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗಿವ್ ಅ ದ ಪೌಡರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟು ಅ ಪೇಷಂಟ್. ಅವ್ರ ಮನೇಲಿ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಹಿಂಗೆ ಧೂಪನ ಯಂತ್ರ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಇರ್ತದಲ್ಲ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಅವ್ರು ಸ್ಪ್ರಿಂಕಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ನಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ. ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ತರ ಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಪೌಡರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗಿವ್.
ಓಕೆ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಇದು ಅದು ಮಾಡಿ ಮಾರ್ಬೋದಲ್ಲ ಮೇಡಮ್.
ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಯ್ಯೋ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೀನಿ ನೋಡು, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಾನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೀನಿ. See, so nice texture is there. ಇದು ನೀವು ಆರಾಮಾಗಿ ಮಾರಿ ಮಾರ್ಬೋದು. ಅಂಡ್
ಅಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ನೀವೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ.
ಓಕೆ ಫೈನ್, ನಂದೊಂದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್, ಬೇರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ನಡೆದ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇದೊಂದು ನಡೆಸ್ತೇನೆ ನಾನು. ಇವ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಡಪ್ಪ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಳಿಸ್ಲಿ, ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು? ನೋ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಕೋ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಲಿ ಒನ್, ಚೀಪರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ.
ಮೇಡಮ್, ಧೂಪನ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಹೊನ್ನಪ್ಪಲ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳಿದ?
ಹೌದು ಹೌದು,
ಅದು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಹೊನ್ನಪ್ಪಲ ಹಾಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ ಅದರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ.
ಹೌದು 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 ಹೌದು,